not that good at all. His young squad haven't been without a scare or two either on the way to this final.
Well, finally, the corner will arrive. And the header's in! Terrific goal for Luis Fabiano. Alex. Perfect run here. A real chance for the opening goal, Adriano! Fabulous finish. Oh, lovely pass, and they could have swayed through the Costa Rican defence here, and a goal! Now Brazil hunting a third goal. Oh, and they've got it! Renato. Gustavo Neri. Here's Adriano! Hat-trick! Terrific header from Julio Gonzalez. Taken on by Cleverson. Oh, what a goal! Fantastic, Luis Fabiano! Oh, good header. And they're stretched here, Brazil. Goal for Paraguay! Freddy Barreiro makes it 2-1. Decent ball forward. Adriano is striding clear of the Mexican defence, blocked by Sanchez. Now then, as he made contact, Adriano's gone to ground, and the referee has pointed to the penalty spot. Makes no mistake. And Brazil deservedly have the lead. Adriano. Oh! Terrific strike. Here's Adriano, though, trying to slot the third. He does. Oh, the shot's on here, and it may fall for Adriano. Oh, brilliantly done. Ricardo Oliveira makes it 4-0. In by Delgado. Oh, the flashing header's in. It's a goal for Uruguay. Marcelo Sosa. Here's Alex. Transfers the ball very quickly and intelligently. It's Fabiano, and Adriano's in there! And he scores yet again! It's Brazil's first choice penalty taker, Alex, who can step forward now and drive Brazil into a final against Argentina on Sunday. He's normally very cool from the spot. He is again. And the final on Sunday is Brazil against Argentina.
Well, despite that nervous start against Chile, they'd already qualified before they lost to Paraguay, finished second in Group C. Mexico followed, and then those penalties against Uruguay. Let's just confirm that Brazilian team then. They're unchanged for the third consecutive game. Goalkeeper Julio Cesar saving that decisive penalty. He's in there. Benfica defender Luisao, ever present in the team during the tournament. Captain Alex, 40th cap tonight. He's supported in midfield by the Premiership duo, of course, of Edu and Cleverson. In attack, the competition's top scorer, six-goal Adriano, continues his partnership with Sao Paulo's Luis Fabiano. Trevor, it's not really the way in South America to play the two frontmen. Quite often it's one up, one just behind, but they do this, Brazil, and that's perhaps why Argentina have changed this at the back.
Yeah, when you look at that side, it's going to be difficult for most of that side to, you know, attempt to replace some of the established stars. But I think in the front two, obviously you're looking at Ronaldo, who's still going to be around for a little while, but what I feel is that the two front players, Adriano and Fabiano, are of a high class, and they prove that in this tournament. And I think they've got a good blend together. They work well together. You know, Fabiano tends to prefer centre-right. Adriano, very left-footed, does a lot of his good work on the left-hand side. So it's quite a good blend.
OK, let's talk about those two then, shall we? Fabiano, 11 caps, 6 goals, Bobby. How good has he been in this tournament?
I think he started the tournament better than his comrade, Adriano. He got this wonderful header late on in the game. He really takes this one magnificently well from such an acute angle. The ball control, the desire then not to look up, he knows he's going to hammer it, and he's hammered it at the target, and it's flew past the keeper. And I thought he started off the tournament very well. Then Adriano has grown in confidence, and as the goals have gone in, you've started to see him become a lot not stronger physically and mentally. And he's got about the pitch. Ray Houghton, who's also been sharing his spot with us, was very critical of his work rate, but of late we've seen him work really, really hard as a duo. And as we know in professional football, if your front two play well, Rob, your team plays well.
What we didn't realise, Bob, was that earlier in the tournament, quite a number of the Brazilian games were being played at altitude, and that definitely affected the team, and it affected Adriano. Since they've come back to sea level, I think Adriano has worked so much harder for the team. And we'll see that tonight.
He's got 6 goals so far in this tournament. He came back from Inter after their midwinter break. 9 in his last 16 games of the last season, Trevor. I mean, there is always the worry that they rely too much on Ronaldo, Brazil. Have they found in these two, perhaps, people who can take over the mantle?
Yeah, I think they have. And as I say, Adriano is predominantly left-footed and gets most of his goals in this tournament with his left foot. But you know, this is an example of his power in his shooting. I mean, it's like a hammer, that left foot. This is an occasion when he actually scores with his right foot. It's a poor mistake by the keeper, but he's at an acute angle and he puts it in with his right foot. So it's another good finish. This is where Fabiano's at his best. On the right-hand side, he drives it across goal. Adriano gets in front of the defender. There's a little touch into the goal.
Trevor and I have been talking, and we've been saying, like, if an English side wanted a centre-forward on loan, go and get Adriano from Inter Milan.
Well, he has scored 6 goals in this Copa America. Saviola, who, of course, is left out tonight by Argentina, is on 3. Bueno of Uruguay on 3. Tevez in that list. He's got 2 in 2, though. Adriano, are you gonna? Would you have money if you were a betting man, Trevor, on him finding the back of the net in this game?
I think he's always capable of scoring because he's a natural goal scorer. Whenever he gets the ball in possession, he's always trying to make himself a yard of space, because you know that no matter where he is, he could be 25 yards from goal, he would try and get a shot in on goal. And the majority of the time, he actually hits the target.
Uruguay proved stiff competition for Brazil, didn't they, in the semi-final? They went at them, they rattled them at times. Would Argentina and Bielsa have picked anything out of that one?
Well, the team selection, the quandaries that we've got here, which is the system, that has happened to Bielsa. Having his team play so well against Colombia, he's frightened about these two front strikers, and he's trying to make sure he can nullify them. But if those two come alight, then they can set Brazil off on a good footing. But I just feel that in midfield, Alex, if Argentina play 3 in there, as talented as he is, Rob, he could get overrun. And they could lose a very positive direction from Alex if he doesn't get the ball.
We felt on the night that Uruguay were unlucky not to go through. They were the better side. And it's quite noticeable that Brazil were quite happy to go to penalties. What we didn't realise was that Carlos Pereira had said that for 3 successive days in training, they've been practising penalties. And you could see by the quality of the penalty, every one was a superb penalty.
Well, the Estadio Nacional, 45,574. They all want to be there for this one. You can be there. It's, what is it now? Coming up to 3:15 in Lima, 9:15 in the UK. And the stadium beginning to buzz ahead of the Copa America final. Now, since the Copa America was changed to its current format in 1993, it's Brazil who have been the most successful nation. 4 times they've made it to the final, the last of which, well, that was back in 1999.
The referee sees Jose Roberto go down. There's another booking. Oh, the touch has taken it in from Rivaldo. So the free kick was very costly. Lunging in, but Brazil keeping the ball. They do have the firepower. They certainly have the firepower. Rivaldo. And Brazil could round it all off here. They go 3-0, and Ronaldo puts his trademark so soon after the restart on this Copa America final. That's what it's been all about over the last 2.5 weeks. 26 games, and Brazil, undoubtedly the best.
Well, to 1999, add 1919, 22, 49, 89 and 97. Brazil, 6 times winners of this. Compare that, Bobby, to Argentina, 14 times winners of this tournament. Why the difference there?
That's a great question. We've only been students since 99 of this. We've followed it since 1999. Rob, I haven't got the answer to that, to be perfectly honest. And whether Argentina have taken more of an interest in this final, like we've seen Brazil now withdrawing their players, and we realise why they're doing it, but a better man than me can answer that, I'm afraid.
Trevor?
Possibly that over the years, you know, Brazil have, you know, seen this competition as one for experimenting, you know, whereas possibly, you know, Argentina have gone with more experienced players. It's interesting on this occasion, you know, Argentina were obviously disappointed they didn't feature in the last one. It was their decision not to go to the one in Colombia. But they've certainly put a good squad out to make sure they try and win it this occasion.
So, will it be 7 times winners Brazil, or will Argentina make it a record-breaking 15 times champions of South America? The answer to that question is almost upon us. Argentina against Brazil, the kickoff coming up. Make sure you stay with us. It should be a night to remember.
Season gets closer. 3 of the Premiership's top sides get ready. See champions Arsenal in the Amsterdam tournament on Friday. Newcastle come head-to-head with Rangers in the Newcastle Gateshead Cup on Saturday. And Manchester United host the Vodafone Tournament of Champions next Tuesday. In association with Sky Bet, the pre-season tournament triple starts Friday, 5:30, Sky Sports 1.
Just begun. Take your bridesmaids on the honeymoon and have yourself some fun. And should you start to pine for the love that you once had, remember the old saying, boys become just like their dads. 'Cause everything's fantastic. Everything's fantastic.
Three fantastic breaks to be won every day for you and 3 mates with Fanta and lastminute.com.
The powerful performance of Dactar in dual action spray powder beats athlete's foot and helps prevent it coming back.
Every day, National Express takes over 50,000 people to more than 1,000 destinations and brings them home again.
Coors Fine Light Beer. Epic refreshment.
Shrek 2 is the family film of the year. Even funnier than the original. Five stars.
Whatever happens, I must not cry.
Shrek 2.
New Lynx Recover Shower Gel with added Lynx effect.
Damn, Nicorette. This new freshman gum is killing us. Look.
I've got a craving right now.
Try this new freshman gum. It tastes really nice.
Look at that coward.
So minty, but so tasty.
Now you're so fired. Get out. You're fired. Hang on a second. Now you can go.
New Freshmint, the best tasting gum ever from Nicorette.
Well, I imagine you wish you'd put your money on Columbia then, Clive.
Well, I imagine you with your mouth taped shut, Brian.
Sky Bet. It matters more when there's money on it.
Five to nine in the UK, 5-3 in the afternoon in Lima. Argentina, Brazil is just a matter of minutes away. Will the year 2004 be added to 1921, 25, 27, 29, 1937, 41, 45, 46, 47, 55, 57, 59, 91 and 93, the years that Argentina have been successful in this tournament, or can Brazil make it seventh heaven in the Copa America? Bobby and Trevor are alongside me here. You can almost touch the kickoff now. Trevor, if Argentina do win this game, it's something you've noted throughout this tournament, that Brazil are suspect from set pieces, from corners and from balls into the box, aren't they?
I've noticed they've lost two goals on corners against Costa Rica and Paraguay, and a free kick against Uruguay. And I think part of the reason is Adriano. He's good at one end of the field, but when he has to come back and defend, he continually loses man. Here, this is against Gonzalez, and the keeper gets him out of the mire there with a wonderful save. This is another example. The mark in there is atrocious. That's not Adriano's fault on this occasion, but he has been guilty, especially in the game against Uruguay. Now, this is the one I was on about. That is very poor marking. It's Adriano's detail to mark Gonzalez, a free header, and it's in the back of the net. It's another example of them pushing out. Neri is left in there. And once again, Julio's his arm. It's a fantastic save from Batista. And he's been one of the outstanding keepers. This is the one where Adriano comes back again. He's marking Sosa. It's a poor attempt by Julio Cesar, but the initial header, Adriano there, doesn't show any bravery at all, doesn't relish heading the ball. And tonight it's going to be important because it'll be interesting. This is a key factor, this. Will he be detailed tonight to mark Ayala? Because there's no better person at attacking set pieces than what Ayala is.
Ayala, only 5'10". He regularly, though, throughout the season in Spain, outjumps players of 6-foot-plus. Bobby, the bookies make Argentina favourite 5-4. Very quickly, do you concur with that? Are we going to see Argentina winners of this one?
What we've seen so far, I believe that Argentina will win this game. If Brazil are going to win it, they've got to be right in the faces of the experienced players of Argentina. And the two front players, Adriano and Fabiano, have really got to get the three at the back a good running into a position of getting goal-scoring opportunities.
Well, it's a fixture full of history. It's 11 against 11 tonight, unlike when they played a friendly back in 1920. It was 8 versus 8. Three Brazilians refused to play after insults from Argentinian newspapers. The Argentines decided to level up the numbers. No such shenanigans ahead of the Copa America final 2004. Lima is the venue, the Estadio Nacional. It is the final that most neutrals would have wanted. Argentina against Brazil. Let's join your commentary team for this one, David Provin and Kevin Keating.
Thank you, Rob. It's a simply wonderful atmosphere in the Nacional Stadium in Lima. You get the feeling that if these two old and bitter rivals were playing a game of tiddlywinks, they'd get 40,000 to turn up and watch, and it would probably be a feisty affair as well. And let's check on the two teams. First of all, it's Argentina And Roberto Ayala is back after being harshly sent off in the quarter-final against Peru. And Mauro Rosales starts for the first time in this Copa America 2004 after four previous substitute appearances. Javier Delgado and Luciano Figueroa drop to the substitutes bench. As for Brazil, well, Carlos Alberto Pereira names the same starting 11 for the third consecutive match. Skipper Alex is by far the most experienced of this 11. He wins his 40th cap tonight, and it's an all-premiership midfield duo there of Cleverson of Manchester United and Arsenal's Edu. Well, the whole stadium is a mass of colour, yellow and green, blue and white, wherever you look. Two very experienced skippers. Roberto Ayala winning his 91st cap for his country this evening. And Alex, big competition for him to try and win his place back in the first choice Brazilian 11. But there is plenty of good quality ahead of him currently. But just a reminder, Brazil have sent their B team here. Their coach, Carlos Alberto Pereira, believes they're the only nation that could bring a reserve side to a major tournament and reach the final. And he's probably right. Great match to look forward to. Alongside me, awaiting it just as eagerly as we all are, is Davy Proven.
Yeah, I think we can understand why Argentina are favourites, Kevin. If they bring their semi-final form into this match, I think they should win it. And I don't think it's too difficult to see where Bielsa is coming from in changing to a back three tonight from his normal flat back four. I think it makes perfect sense to have Colaccini in there beside Ayala and Hines. It gives them that little bit extra security against the front pairing that are undoubtedly the best in the tournament so far. He also has Mascherano sitting just in front as well, so there's no real exposure there for Argentina at the back. And more importantly, it allows Zanetti and Sorin to push on either side. They're not going to have to worry too much tonight about tucking in and covering centre-backs. They can bomb on, and the evidence of what we've seen so far, no one does it better.
Well, since the format of the Copa Americas switched in 1993, Brazil are figuring in their fourth final in five tournaments, and Argentina looking for their first senior international title in 11 years. They might have a lucky omen in the referee. Carlos Amaria of Paraguay has taken charge of two games in this tournament, both featuring Argentina, a 6-1 win against Ecuador and that quarter-final 1-0 victory against the hosts, Peru. Tevez, number 11, scorer in his last two games in this tournament. Just going to see in the opening minutes exactly how Argentina approach things in an attacking sense. We've talked about Rosales coming in for his first start, whether he'll be the lone striker up front. We expect Tevez to play in his usual role just behind the one striker. But Marcelo Bielsa certainly had the opposition in mind in terms of his starting 11 tonight. Fabulous final in prospect. Here's Colaccini. Alex drifting away from Mascherano. This is Adriano. Now Zanetti. It's going to be interesting down this near side. Javier Zanetti and Adriano are club mates in Italy at Inter Milan.
And the thing that impresses me so much about Zanetti isn't just the way he gets byline to byline, Kevin, but it's his delivery, his final ball. He has the delivery of a natural white player.
Sorry. Held up well by Edu. This is Cleverson. Theatrical dive, in the opinion of the referee. Certainly didn't appear to be any contact from Heinze.
Well, this will clear it up. There's a bit of contact. Certainly caught on his left calf there.
This is Tevez. Edu. Adriano, beautiful turn away from Bollicini. What a tournament he's having. He might go all the way here, Adriano. And it needed a very, very good interception to prevent a shot on target, but he was certainly posting the danger signals here.
Well, they had good numbers to outside Argentina when he picked up the ball, but all of a sudden he turned Colaccini, and he was almost in behind there, but for the intervention of Zanetti.
A terrific start to the match. We expected an open game, both sides potentially full of goals, as they have been throughout this tournament. Argentina with 14, Brazil have managed 11. Free kick against Luis Fabiano.
Doubt about that one. The one thing that does surprise me tonight is that Figueroa has been left out. He didn't work out at Birmingham, but I think he's put in a terrific shift for him so far.
Here comes the shot, and Julio Cesar decided he would make an attempt to save. The ball was travelling wide from Zanetti's shot, and it spills from the goalkeeper for a corner.
I think it took an upward kick just in front of the goalkeeper, did the right thing, got it behind, gives him a chance to organise.
Rosales to take. Brazil have every right to be nervous from set pieces. They've been ill at ease throughout this Copa America 2004. Argentina will be well aware of that. Again, they look for the flick on at the near post, and half hearted appeals for possible use of the arm or hand. Zanetti. Rosales. Work for Luis out.
I don't think the defender knew anything about this. Too much pace in the ball for him to do anything else but get in the way of it. Argentina starting to feel their way into the game.
Ayala will be going as one of the three over-age players to the Olympics next month. Eight of this starting 11 will be in Greece for the Olympic tournament. This is Sorry looking for the run there of Tevez.
Looks as if they're going to play almost without a centre-forward tonight, Argentina. Rosales playing wide right, but Delgado would have played. Tevez playing off, but they don't really have a figurehead up front.
The kick goes against Adriano. Mascherano has been a real find for Argentina in this tournament. Zanetti. Terrific storming run, so typical of Javier Zanetti. He's not getting a free kick.
Yeah, I think he was looking for that. But interestingly enough, you saw it was Edu who had to track him on the left-hand side a moment ago, and it's going to be a tough shift for Edu tonight. Javier playing when his team has the ball, but going to have to track Zanetti down that right-hand side this evening.
Gilly Gonzalez. Bollicini. Good turn from Rosales. Roberto doing a fine marking job on Zanetti. Here's Alex.
No!
Excellent tempo about the opening 7 minutes. Cleverson gets away from his soon-to-be Manchester United teammate Heinze, but across came the experienced figure of Ayala.
This is a Zanetti appeal. Oh, I think he's looking for that. Very little contact there.
Gabriel Heinze, who will be going to the Olympics, much to the annoyance of Sir Alex Ferguson, who would naturally have wanted him at the start of the new Premiership season.
Well, this early in the game, no one getting any room at all, particularly in the midfield area. And the real pastors of the ball, Keely Gonzalez and Alex, are going to have to work for any bit of room to get this evening. Good example there again.
Zanetti. Rosales trying to play in Tevez, who just made his run a split second too soon.
We're just a fraction early here, blindside of Juan. Otherwise, he would have been in. So much resting in the shoulders of Tevez tonight. D'Alessandro was indeed fit tonight. Anything but pleased to be left out this evening.
Zanetti. Good steal by Gustavo Neri. Might be something on here now for Brazil. Keeper manages to prevent the corner.
Well, it was Mascherano who got across there, Kevin. Zanetti caught forward, Mascherano preventing the cover.
Pretty quick against Luis Zhao. Tevez has drawn comparisons with Maradona, something he could do without at the age of 20, but similar stature, isn't he? Certainly has a potential for goals. This free kick being a little closer, I'm sure he would have been striking for the target. As it is, it's played in by Rosales. Header away. He's drifted out for an Argentinian corner. And Ayala, both very strong in the air. And it was Sorin who stooped and got the rather awkward header in, but he managed to plant it on target.
He's unlucky, it's just slightly behind them, but you can see, even this early in the match, the difficulty Brazil have at times defending set pieces. Nobody tight on Sorin as it came into the six-yard box.
He's a real handful in the opposition half. Juan Pablo Sorin, like a left winger, really, rather than a left back. It's a wing back role tonight as Bielsa has gone, as Davey was saying earlier, to three centre backs. It's a formation they used in part of their World Cup qualifying in the 2002 World Cup when they went out in the first group stage, and he got a real hammering, the coach, for that. And here come Brazil menacingly. Decent cross, scored by Abondanzieri. Goalkeeper happy to see a defender in the right place. Brazil threatened again. Oh, right across the face of goal from Adriano.
Well, this was the first danger here. Difficult to pick out anyone from this angle. Goalkeeper makes a bit of a hash of it. Colaccini well placed at the front post. And then Adriano again, posting an early warning that if they give him any room at all, they're going to be punished. Difficult to find a weakness, sorry Kevin, in this fella's game. At 22 years of age, he appears to have it all.
He's even outscored Ronaldo and Rivaldo. They've got five apiece back in this tournament in 1999. six goals for Adriano as he hunts possession. Tidied up comfortably by the Argentinians. It's out of play. Zanetti, who turned down the opportunity to go to the Olympics, wants to concentrate on his club football in Italy with Inter this coming season.
The pressure they're putting on Fabiano, even as deep as that, he's just over the halfway line. Pressed every time he gets the ball.
Mason, one of six players given their senior international debuts by Pereira in this competition. Gilly Gonzalez, super pass, and this is Rosales. And it's a good 2 or 3 yards wide of that far post.
That's a decent chance, Kevin. It's a delightful diagonal. It was played early enough to keep him onside, but the first touch let him down, took him away from goal. And by the time he strikes it here, the angle is doing him no favours. Not going to beat Cesar from there.
Plays his club football with the Newell's old boys. Rosales hasn't scored for Argentina. It's his ninth cap tonight. Alex. Mario Zagallo, you may have spotted just behind Carlos Alberto Pereira, the great old man of Brazilian football. Zagallo, well into his 70s now. This is Mascherano. Luis Gonzalez. And again. Once again, the approach play from Argentina. Gordon, we've seen that throughout this competition.
Well, I think Zanetti's enjoying the freedom he's getting tonight. He doesn't really have to worry too much about defensive responsibilities. He has complete license to get down there inside on the right. And he's far higher up the pitch, even this early in the match, than he was in the semi-final.
Mauro Rosales with the Argentina corner. Better defending from Brazil. Free kick against Mascherano. Only 20. Plays with the River Plate club.
I think that'll be his job tonight, making sure that Alex isn't supplying the Brazilian front two. Remarkable composure and assurance about him for a 20-year-old.
No nonsense challenge, so typical of Ayala. I don't think there are too many better centre-backs in world football today than Ayala. Now, Alex with the Brazil corner. Quarter an hour gone of the Copa America final. Snap effort from the fullback, Mason. Gonzalez, it's too long for Rosales. Argentina haven't won this competition since 1993. They've gone out in the quarter-final stage in each of the last three times they've been in it. This is Adriano as well to dig out the cross. And Luis Fabiano has been penalised. Seemed to be very little contact on Heinze. Pereira's furious.
I think he's unlucky there, but terrific play in the wide area from Adriano. Under real pressure from Colaccini, somehow managed to dig the cross out. And eventually Argentina pretty fortunate to get the award.
Poor clearance by Abbondanzieri, who's reputed to be the best goalkeeper in the Argentinian league. Winning only his seventh cap, the goalkeeper, he's 31 now. Caballero of Celta Vigo in Spain is the recognised number one. There's no question that Argentina brought the strongest squad of all the 12 competing nations to this tournament. And were installed as favourites. They've certainly lived up to the billing. Tevez. Important interception there from Luisão. Best of clearances from Julio Cesar. Brazil consequently on the back foot. Fabiano. Strong work from Mainza. Who's going to be used? Manchester United manager says as a left back. Certainly a good option for Manchester United as a pretty decent centre back as well, Gabriel Heinze. That was a late challenge on Adriano.
Yeah, I don't think Colaccini will be allowed too many more of them. Every chance he gets, he's nailing him on the turn.
Free kick again against a rather perplexed looking Fabiano. Here's Kili Gonzalez. Tevez trying to find the overlapping run there of Sorin. Offside.
A couple of yards early. Looking across at the last defender, shouldn't have been caught in that position.
Sloppy play there by Mason. Oh, now then, penalty. Referee not in any doubt. Horrible mistake by Mason. And Luisão with the covering tackle has conceded the penalty.
Yeah, Luis Gonzalez just followed his pass there. Horrible misjudgment from the defender. I don't think it's a difficult one for the referee. Stonewaller for me.
But all the damage came from the cheap possession given away by the fullback Mason. And then a rush of blood to the head from Luisão, bringing down Luis Gonzalez, and Kili Gonzalez has the chance now to sweep Argentina into the lead in the 2004 Copa America final. No more experienced a player than Inter Milan's Kili Gonzalez, once at Valencia, the 29-year-old. Steps up and makes no mistake. And the favourites lead.
We've seen it so often in penalties in this tournament, Kevin. Players going down the middle, goalkeepers taking a guess and regretting it. And again, it's straight down the goalkeeper's throat. Had he stayed up, he might have saved it. Takes his chance. But Argentina really have settled into this game.
The 75th goal of the Copa America 2004 in this, the 26th and final match. A test now for this young and inexperienced Brazil squad. Been one missed penalty in this tournament. Mason. Adriano beautifully done. Son looking for some movement off the ball. It's all a little bit tight as far as Brazil are concerned. It's not a good clearance by Sorry. Here's Cleverson. Argentina getting themselves into a mess. It's a Brazil corner. Skipper Alex to take. Luis Ao and Juan, the two centre-backs, are forward. Flashing header was from Gustavo Neri.
Yeah, it's a decent ball in, but he's so far outside the front post, it's almost impossible to score from that angle. And Argentina, like Brazil at times, have struggled to defend set pieces.
Brazil left-back, who's on his way to Germany, and the current Bundesliga champions, Werder Bremen, at the end of this tournament, leaving Sao Paulo, who sooner or later are going to lose the Brazil striker out here tonight, Luis Fabiano. It's only a matter of when rather than if Luis Fabiano makes a big money move to Europe. A swarm of clubs are currently tracking him. Most notable of those, by the way, are Barcelona and Roma. Here's Cleverson. Room for the cross. It's Cleverson. Good hands. Positive goalkeeping from Juan Dantieri. Tevez. Low centre of gravity. Balance he's got. Here's Rosales. Zanetti firing in the shot, but his free kick against Mauro Rosales.
He was unlucky there, just lost his footing at the crucial moment, otherwise he might have been in. And for me, Argentina the more impressive of the two sides so far. I think there's a better work ethic about them as well when they lose the ball. They really are putting pressure. Brazil finding it very hard to get any time and any space on the ball, particularly Alex, of whom so much was expected tonight. Here's a perfect example.
First booking of the game goes to Juan Pablo Sorín. No doubt about that one. They do, took his eye off it, and Zanetti, chance to get Argentina marching forward again here in the shape of Rosales. That's routine for Julio Cesar. Brazil are currently top of the South American World Cup qualifying group after 7 of the 18 rounds of matches. No side has won more than 3 though. Brazil are unbeaten in their 7. Argentina just behind them. And those World Cup qualifiers resume again in September. Argentina will be at home to Uruguay in the next match. Brazil also at home, they'll play Bolivia. This is all about the bragging rights in the continent of South America. First major final for the Argentinian coach Marcelo Bielsa. Zanetti. Ayala. Rock it out by Mason. Here's Heinze. Gonzalez. Shots on now! Oh, right save by Julio Cesar. Very important fingertips.
That's terrific build-up with the man who won on the penalty, again stepping off the midfield. Could have taken the shot here, decided to take a touch. All of a sudden, things opened up for him. And that's a fine save. Horrible height for the goalkeeper.
Another of the big finds for Argentina. 23-year-old Luis Gonzalez of River Plate. Goalkeeper with a good fist away. Mascherano. Ayala getting free, and the flag is against him in the end.
Well, this must have been tight. He's looking right across at the last defender. He reckons he's on here. As it's played, well, it's not Ayala, right back's playing him on, but it may have been the forward in the middle there who spun round, who had been coming out originally when the ball was played. Pereira must have been surprised when he got the Argentinian team sheet. He must have been expecting Figueroa to start. As it is, they're playing really without a centre forward. Tevez is playing through the middle, but he's dropping off. Rosales is playing wide right. And the two Brazilian centre-backs at times really don't have anyone to play against.
Certainly an unusual system, that's for sure. Heinze. Sloppy pass from Maidu. Sorin. Now Cleverson. Tackles are firm and swift from Argentina. Tevez. Rosales, unable to pick out Rosales. Adriano.
I think Brazil at the moment are struggling to match Argentina's appetite for closing the ball down when they don't have it. A real appetite for that tonight. Yet when Argentina have it, Brazil aren't as willing to get in about them and make sure that they don't get any space or time.
Sixth game for both these nations, of course, as they've gone all the way to the final in this competition, and you wonder whether Brazil's three matches all at altitude up in the Andes in Arequipa might play a part here. Maybe some tired legs. As the game progresses, of course, we've had half an hour, and Argentina deservedly in front, courtesy of Kili Gonzalez's penalty. Well, that's better closing down from Juan. Alex. Good ball and excellent running off the ball here from Gustavo Neri, but how quick Rosales was to get back. Certainly this is going to be the team to beat in the Athens Olympics. Argentina have been drawn in a group with Serbia and Montenegro, who they play on the 11th of August, then Tunisia 3 days later, and then Australia on the 17th. Good running, excellent running there by Alex, and he was a little unfortunate not to be able to plant the header on target.
Oh, it certainly was. It's a terrific run. There's no one picking it up, there's no one marking him. Just couldn't direct it on target. So far been anonymous in this game.
Thank you. Zanetti, old pro's trick there, just leaning his body in to Adriano. There's Ayala. Rosales turning away from Gustavo Neri. Covers good from Juan. Adu. Struggling to impose themselves, that trio of Adu, Cleverson and Alex.
I don't think we'd ever write them off, not with the front pairing they have.
No.
But Argentina certainly have the game by the throat right now.
Tomalo! Mano!
Renato.
Mano!
Here's Gustavo Neri. Waste of a good position.
Yeah, it was in a good position. I think that's the downside of Argentina throwing the two wide fullbacks on. There is going to be space down either side, but Colaccini was quick to step out there and make sure that Gustavo Neri didn't have time to lift his head and pick across.
Well, we've got more live football coming up for you this Friday. Arsenal, River Plate, Ajax, Panathinaikos, not bad. Sky Sports 1, 5:30. Excellent tournament, that promises to be. Excellent tournament, Copa America has been. Argentina lead their bitterest and oldest rivals, Brazil, by a goal to nil. Looking to exact some revenge as well after Brazil beaten 3-1 last month in a World Cup qualifier in the Brazilian city of Belo Horizonte. Ronaldo scored a hat-trick of penalties. Here's Alex. Adriano. Room now for Kili Gonzalez. Tevez. Mascherano. Sorin. Lee Gonzalez winning the corner out of Renato. Argentina do win, incidentally, this afternoon. The local time is just beyond 25-4. They will win a Copa America for a record 15th time. They're currently tying with Uruguay. In by Rosales. On ball, surely. Referee couldn't have been closer. Clearly didn't spot it. Work rate from Tevez.
Certainly was.
There's a sort of Wayne Rooney enthusiasm about Carlos Tevez, isn't there?
Oh, it's just so helpful for your midfield players, Kevin, if your forwards are defending like that.
Still only 20, Tevez. What a prospect. South American Player of the Year at 19. Benfica. This is Juan. Storming run from the centre-back. About the final pass. And a yellow card for Edu.
That's a terrific run by Juan. All of a sudden he was almost on the edge of the Argentinian box here. Eventually Ayala had to step out to him. This is Luis Gonzalez being caught here by Edu.
I once saw Juan when he was playing in Brazil with Flamengo go all the way from the penalty spot at his own end to about the penalty spot in the opposition's half and score a fantastic solo goal. He went beyond about eight players on that occasion. Just wondered for a moment whether he was going to do the same there. Certainly a spirit of adventure, wasn't it? Here's Sorin. Oh, and nearly fell for Rosales. It will for Zanetti. Touch away by Luisao. Argentina threatening, but Julio Cesar takes all the pressure off his defenders.
It was a miss hit across goal there by Sorin, but it almost fell nicely for Rosales, who came in blindside of Gustavo Neri.
Yeah, I think he was trying to shot, Davey, wasn't it? Nearly turned into a great pass. Zanetti. Mascherano. Distributed the ball quite superbly, the holding midfield player Mascherano in this tournament. Here's Tevez, and he's going to get on the return here. Oh, and good save by Julio Cesar to prevent what would have been a tap-in for Luis Gonzalez.
That's a terrific little exchange though from Tevez to get him in behind in the first place. Just continues his run, delightful outside of the football from Gonzalez. And he almost got the return ball, but for good goalkeeping.
Adriano. Cleverson. Still Cleverson. Couldn't find a pass, eventually caught the save out of Abbondanzieri. Miraculously kept in by Rosales.
This is a good play by Cleverson, under pressure from Sorin. Made a little bit of room, trying to find the top right-hand corner. Because he'll need a little bit more of that kind of enterprise.
Here's Fabiano. Is there a particular area that Brazil need to step up, Davey, in your opinion, to get back into this?
Well, I think they need genuine width, but I don't see where it's going to come from, Kevin. I think that's been the problem throughout the tournament. They've defended very heavily on the front here. And I think tonight, so far anyway, and you would never write them off, but Fabiano and Adriano have had very little change out of this Argentinian back three, who so far have been absolutely rock solid. No coincidence that it's Ayala's back in the side tonight.
Of course, Brazil normally get so much from their first choice fullbacks, but with all due respect to Mason and Gustavo Neri, they're not Cafu and Roberto Carlos. Sorry. Fabiano. Now Mason. Juan.
Ahora Pumbi!
Edu. No progress for Gustavo Neri. Hard-working Rosales in the picture again. Certain amount of concern there on the face of Carlos Alberto Pereira. Now, Adriano.
Normally expect better from him. Did well to make the space on the outside of Colaccini. A little bit dispirited at the moment.
Vamos, Carlito!
This young Brazilian squad, average age 24, have done better than the squad of 3 years ago, which surprisingly went out in the quarterfinals to Honduras. They failed to make it three successive Copa America wins. It's Colaccini, who says his agent is talking to Liverpool at the moment about a possible transfer. Sorry, Luis Gonzalez. Short though for Tevez. Here's Juan. Luis Fabiano taking on Heinze. Oh, now then! Contact from Mascherano. What's the referee given here? A free kick. I'd like to see that again. It was desperately close to being a penalty.
Well, it must have been first time that Fabiano's really managed to get turned and running at defenders. Well, it's just outside. On the line counts as inside. It's maybe a fraction outside the line here. So close.
Well, they are the margins between success and failure, really. That's just off the line as Alex spots up the free kick. Move forward into the mix. Alex plays it in, and it's going to fall now for Cleverson. Gustavo Neri.
They might be glad to hear the half-time whistle, Argentina. This is the best spell Brazil have had in the match. And I think significantly, Kevin, if you look at the penalty claim, it's one of the few times that either Adriano or Fabiano have managed to get turned and running at defenders. They backed off for the first time.
Two Brazilian strikers have got 15 goals in 25 caps between them. Here's Gustavo Neri. Yes, he'll get the free kick. By Rosales. It's the minimum of 1 minute stoppage time at the end of a more than interesting first half.
Well, this has got to be in range, you would think.
Just wondering sometimes why they don't get the left foot of Adriano over these free kicks.
Yeah, he has the power, yeah.
Alex to help it in. Oh, and it's in! It's a goal for Luisão. And right on the stroke of half-time, Brazil square it up.
That's a wonderful ball in from Alex. It's a horrible ball to defend for defenders. It's in between goalkeeper and last defender. It's not in the air long enough for the goalkeeper to come for it. It's whipped in there. So difficult to defend. The pace is already on it, and a glance is all that's required. Much of it, I think, down to the delivery from Alex, who hasn't really been in the match, but what a telling contribution when most needed.
And what a time to score your first senior international goal. Luisão of Benfica. And it was Argentina who were made to pay for not being able to defend a set piece, but take nothing away from the quality delivery of the skipper, Alex. A penalty from Kili Gonzalez. A header on the stroke of half-time from Luisão. Game on, 1-1.
So it is 1-1 at half-time. And fair results at the break. Well, to answer that question and many more, Bobby and Trevor will get their thoughts out of the break. But the man who conceded the penalty the man who equalised. 1-1 it is at half-time, courtesy of Lewis Au.
They won't respect me for what I truly am.
That man is not a sportsman. He is a devil.
Now listen, the average person believes that I'm a nut and I deserve whatever happened to me.
Oh, it's a great shot, Tyson!
But I never wanted to do anything else but fight.
Mike Tyson reignites the flame!
Tyson v. Danny Williams, Friday from 11 p.m., Sky Box Office. Order this event 48 hours in advance. See Channel 770 or call 08705-800-888.
You got a problem with guns?
Let's just say they take me to a place I don't want to go.
Where do they take you?
The Rock. Welcome to the jungle on DVD. Bam, bam. With awesome special features that'll rock your world.
Ow!
Rent or buy it from Monday.
Hey, Corey. Throat cancer. They've come in and removed my voice box before they did this. They found out I got lung cancer as well.
Call 0800 169 0169.
You're out tonight and you want to look sharp, but you've got oily skin, so you get Nivea for Men Oil Control Moisturiser to moisturise without the shine. Forget about oily skin and get more than your confidence back. Nivea for Men Oil Control Moisturiser. Advanced face care.
Liv!
Kev! Bev!
Kev? Bev? Kev!
Bev! Kev!
With an AA car loan, the typical APR is just 6.6%, so you might surprise yourself with what you can afford.
Nice car.
Thanks! We used to have one of those.
To get more car for your money, call the AA on 0800 374 999 or visit theaa.com. Call now and you can also get a free AA car inspection.
A word of warning. Once you've tried the refreshing taste of Lipton iced tea, you might find it makes you more open to trying other new things. Like impulse buying. Getting waxed. Going natural. Nice. Page 89 of the Kama Sutra. Or being honest.
Yeah, that was me.
Lipton iced tea. Don't knock it until you've tried it.
It. Oh, yes.
My dad loves to go fishing. All you need is the right gear. Well, there's the rod, obviously, reel and lines, nets, a chair, a big umbrella, sandwiches, a lucky hat. Oh, and an Environment Agency rod license. Because without one of these, there's no point in having all the rest.
You can get an Environment Agency rod licence from post offices or on our website. Otherwise, you risk being fined up to £2,500. There's more to life. Go fishing.
Well, it's been a long day for Strahan.
What a lovely shot. Who's the man?
Forget your right guard. Let's start again. Start every day with an upward spray of new Right Guard Total Protection. Its time-released odor protection will never let you down. New Right Guard Total Protection. Start right, end right.
Damn, Nicorette. This new freshman gum is killing us. Look.
I've got a craving right now.
Try this new freshman gum. It tastes really nice.
Look at that coward.
It's so minty. It's so tasty.
Now you're so fired. Get out. You're fired. Hang on a second. Oh! Now you can go.
New Fresh Mint, the best tasting gum ever from Nicorette.
The Colombians victorious. You know, all that ticker tape, Brian, reminds me of your money floating
yes,
away.
Yes, very amusing.
Into the night.
Yes, very funny.
Skybet. It matters more when there's money on it.
20 days and counting till the kickoff of the Premiership, and the best way to follow all the build-up is to stay with us right here on Sky Sports. Sky Sports 1, Friday, 5:30. Arsenal, Ajax, Panathinaikos and River Plate battle it out in the Amsterdam tournament. That's followed by Saturday at noon, also on Sky Sports 1, Newcastle, Rangers, Feyenoord and Sporting Lisbon in the Newcastle Gateshead Cup tournament. And completing the trio of pre-season tournaments to get you in the mood, Manchester United, PSV Eindhoven, Boca Junior and the Uroa Red Diamond. Sky Sports 1, 3rd of August. Right now, we're 45 minutes and perhaps penalties away from the climax of the Copa America 2004. 1-1 it is at half-time. Bobby and Trevor, my guests here in the studio. Trevor, what have you made of that first half? Argentina, they've been solid, they've been strong, but have they really offered enough against a Brazilian side that could be suspect?
They've been the better side, Argentina. I don't think it's a performance to get excited about. I think it's been a tactical battle. I'm interested in the way that they've got the team put out today. It's totally different to how they played against Colombia. There isn't the fluidity that there was against Colombia, but still, it's been a good, solid performance. I think Brazil have struggled because the three at the back for Argentina have totally nullified the threat of Fabiano and Adriano. And apart from those two, they've got nobody else who's prepared to run past them. The two fullbacks, Neri and Mancini, you know, they're being closed down regularly by Kili Gonzalez and Rosales, so there's no natural width for Brazil.
Luis Gonzalez, Bobby, has caught the eye. He was involved in the penalty incident.
Yeah, but the biggest culprit is the defender. Luis out of there, he goes to ground. Look, big, tall, 6'6". Lad, he goes to ground, turns around, he peels. It's a stonewall penalty, as David Provey said. Just watch his feet now. He lunges. The biggest art of defending is to delay, and that puts them 1-0 down. And Kili Gonzalez, his third penalty in this tournament.
I think we're taking these penalties for granted, Bob, aren't we? If you look at the record in this tournament, you know, it's inevitability now that whenever there's a penalty, you just automatically expect whoever's taken it to score.
21 taken, including the penalty shootout, just 2 missed in this Copa America. Perhaps a few England internationals could take note of that one. OK, the equaliser, Luisão, redeeming himself, Trevor, after Neri was fouled by Rosales.
Yeah, I mentioned that the fullbacks haven't been allowed to get forward simply because of the work rate and the closing down of Rosales and on the other side, Kili Gonzalez. But this is the first occasion that Neri got forward. He wins a free kick, and it's a lifeline, isn't it? It's a great ball in from Alex, low trajectory, and Luisão attacks it, gets across the front of the defender, and heads a goal and redeems himself, having given the penalty away. But I think it's probably changed the team talk of Pereira, because I'm sure he would have gone in half-time thinking about possibly making one or two tactical changes, because his side haven't been allowed to function. Argentina have closed them down, they've dominated the midfield, and they really have nullified Brazil. But it's 1-1 at half-time.
It certainly is, Argentina and Brazil. 1-1 at the break. If it stays that way after 90 minutes, it'll go straight to penalties. What will happen? The second half, it's coming your way next.
Like most small firms, we have to make dozens of absolutely vital calls every day.
Hello, Matt.
Is the kettle on? I'm gasping.
See what I mean? Vital. I can't function without the tea.
Save us a steak and kidney.
An army marches on its stomach.
Those mobile calls we make to the people we work with, wouldn't it help if they were free? With Vodafone Perfect Fit for Business, they are.
Low on Garibaldi's. Right. Staff biscuits, total priority.
Vodafone. Free calls between your company mobiles.
Spoke to Norwich Union Direct last week about my car insurance. They did quote me happy. Took their offer up straight away. So it was quite reassuring when I ran into an old pal in town. I didn't do much damage. Scratched the paintwork a bit, scraped down the offside, took his hubcaps off, dent in the bumper.
Call 0800 828 829 and let Norwich Union Direct quote you happy.
Makes me wish I was a blue whale.
Why?
Because the blue whale's got the biggest tongue in the whole world. Taste buds like basketballs. Over here, you got your sweet taste buds. Here, your bitter taste buds. Strongbow, unlike most other drinks, gets them both very excited.
Cheers.
Bitter, sweet, Strongbow. It's what your taste buds would order.
Euro 2004, the official review.
Oh, a picture goal!
Rooney, unbelievable!
He's done it again!
Oh, fantastic! Greece have done it!
Euro 2004, the official review. Buy it now on DVD.
Do you ever feel everything is the same?
Same, same, same. Oh, enough of the same.
Time to try something different. Like beekeeping.
Hey, here you go.
Perfect.
Oh, ow. Hey, do you think I could buy a thicker bee suit?
Open doors with Barclay Card. The key.
Only one breakdown company can make this promise to its personal members. To fix your car by the road or get you another one on us. To make sure you're not left stranded, join the AA now from just £35. Call 0800 444 999 or buy online.
We humans are always trying to go faster.
Which is why more and more people are filing their tax return online.
The calculations are done instantly.
And most importantly, you'll get anything you own faster.
Self-assessment online. Tax doesn't have to be taxing.
Fire.
The amazing new Thunderbirds movie is about to be launched.
Four.
And you can get a free family ticket for four to see it.
Three.
By visiting your local Ford dealer right now.
Two.
And test driving any new Ford.
One.
Be one of the first to see it. You won't want to miss it.
Thunderbirds are go.
Something is about to happen.
Here's Ricard.
Oh, no! He moved! Ref! Anything! Handball! Anything! Do it again!
Skybet. It matters more when there's money on it.
Live boxing coming up on Friday night, live from Louisville, Kentucky. It's heavyweight action as Iron Mike Tyson takes on Danny Williams. That's preceded by a bill from London, including Graham Earl against Steve Murray for the British lightweight title. It all starts from 11 p.m. live only on Sky Box Office. For more information, call 08705 800 888. Right now, the climax of the Copa America is the final. Argentina against Brazil, 1-1 at halftime. Bobby Gould and Trevor Francis, my guests here in the studio. Trevor, Marcelo Bielsa, did he get his tactics right in this game?
Well, if they'd gone in 1-0 up, you'd have said yes. I think whenever you change personnel like he did, I mean, he dropped Figueroa, who has done very well in the last three or four games for Argentina. But more importantly than the personnel, he's changed the actual shape of the side. Having performed so fantastically well against Colombia, he's changed the, you know, to a back three. So I think when you do something like that, you must win the game. Doesn't matter what happens during the game. If you win it, you can sort of, you know, just skate over anything you do. But at the moment, you know, from being the dominant force, they've gone in at 1-1, and it's anyone's game now, second half.
Bobby, I mean, on paper, I don't think many people would argue going into this game that Argentina had a better team and a better squad on paper. Why has he worried more about the strengths of Brazil than the power of his own side?
There comes the fear element. That's the only thing you can say about the coach. He wants to win, and he thinks the fear element can be in a position of helping his side by playing another system. Now, the system, we raved about Zanetti and Zorin. We have hardly seen them attack from those positions. I said, if they're going to get the balls in the right position, now Zorin's asked to come in and mark Cleberson and then drift out. He's got Gonzalez in front of him. On the other side, Rosales is in front of Zanetti. And they haven't got their space to run in, Rob. That's where they're being nullified. That's why we haven't seen them playing from their attacking forces.
I think a big problem too is Tevez is a very, very talented player, but he's not a target player. And often he's just dropping back into little deep midfield players to receive the ball. And it's causing a slight problem because Luizio and Juan, they've got nobody to mark. I think they prefer to have somebody playing up against them. But I just think that for all the possession that they've had, you know, they find it difficult to really create enough opportunities because of the actual structure of the side in forward areas.
Well, the two teams have taken their place back on the pitch of the Estadio Nacional, the second half of the 2004 Copa America about to get underway. Let's rejoin our commentary team, David Proven and Kevin Keatings.
Thank you, Rob. 76 goals have now been scored in the 2004 Copa America. Certainly the competition has enjoyed a revival staged here in Peru this year. The competition 3 years ago in Colombia fraught with problems over security worries, enough to mean that Argentina refused to take part. The host Colombia eventually went on to win it. But is it going to be a 15th Copa America win for Argentina or a 7th for Brazil? It's level at 1-1 and all to play for. No substitutions have been made from either side at halftime. When you score on the stroke of half time, it's never a bad time to score a goal, of course. Maybe Carlos Alberto Pereira didn't want to hear the whistle just at that moment. But Luis Ao's header cancelling out that Kili Gonzalez penalty. And a fascinating 45 minutes in prospect here. Mascherano. Ayala. Sorin. It's way beyond the Brazil goal, a run from Kili Gonzalez.
That was a terrific first touch on his left side there, but an unusually poor cross. I think Argentina would be pretty disappointed at going in level at half-time, Kevin. They've been the superior team, undoubtedly. They've just been caught cold on the stroke of half-time there. They've got to start all over again there.
Here's Adriano. Start pacing Ayala there for a moment.
It's not unlike the goal that Luis Fabiano set up for him in the last match, the semi-final. Get it across goal like that, you're always liable to get something.
Here's Fabiano, turned into a little bit of space and then a little slow to offload the pass. Kili Gonzalez got to him, but Brazil have been awarded a free kick.
Well, I don't know why Ayala's complaining, it's a reckless challenge there, he ends up at full stretch. Unfortunately, he hasn't been shown a yellow for this, not that one.
Yeah,
I see the
follow-up.
Second, yep. Oh, it was reckless.
This time Brazil have got Adriano alongside Alex over the free kick. What do Brazil have up their sleeve here? Looks as though it's going to be a shot from Adriano. Would you want to be in that wall? Brave though they were, this is Alex.
Going to take something pretty special to score from that range. But I suppose if any of this Brazilian side is capable, it's this man here. Hey,
They do. Side against the eager Tevez.
I think he's done well tonight. I know what Trevor is saying. He's by no means a back-to-goal striker, but I think he's played the position well. He's dropped off. He's allowed Gonzalez, Luis Gonzalez in particular, to go beyond him. He's linked up well. I still feel he is a major part to play in this match.
Certainly a brave selection from Bielsa. Side to the other there from Gustavo Neri, but he did the tidy up job effectively enough in the end. I can almost sense the knives being sharpened already by the Argentinian press for Bielsa, who will get hammered for not choosing Figueroa should Argentina lose this. Tevez. Zanetti. By Rosales. Oh, it must be a goal now, off the post. What a miss from Tevez.
Oh, that's astonishing. They were queuing up there. Brazil totally exposed at the back post. Had Tevez left it, Sorin's going to tap in. Takes a little nick there at the front post off Luis Gonzalez, I think. What a let off for Brazil.
Well, they're shaking their heads in blue and white striped shirts all around the pitch. What a let-off for Brazil. But back come Argentina again in the shape of Zanetti. He's given it away, though, to Edu. Cleverson. Too strong for the Manchester United man, Mascherano, finding Colaccini. This is Juan. Peru's decision to decentralise the Copa America for the first time in this their sixth hosting of the tournament. Has taken matches to all corners of the country, from the capital here in Lima to the desert north and the Andes. Only the Amazon Basin hasn't hosted a match this time round. Here's Luis Gonzalez. Sorin playing centre forward momentarily, the left wing back. What is he doing up there?
He was almost in too.
He's got a ridiculous sense of adventure sometimes. He's so exciting. Here's Gustavo Neri. Alex. Zanetti. Pass from Luis Gonzalez. Disappointing ball in though from Rosales, but Luis Gonzalez in there again. Same two players involved, which led to the penalty in the first half. Luis now challenging Luis Gonzalez.
I don't think he needed any encouragement to go down though, Kevin. I'm surprised that had been given.
There's no penalty there. Brazil, meantime, with the injury, I think it's Cleverson who's down. Terrific little competitor, isn't he, though,
no, he
Sorin?
He's remarkable.
Plays his football out in France at the moment. He's a difficult player to keep track of, Juan Pablo Sorin. He's with Paris Saint-Germain at the moment. He's also played at Juventus, Lazio, Barcelona. Also had a spell in Brazil, playing with Cruzeiro. Gabriel Heinze is another one who's been around a bit. He's about to play with Manchester United. It'll be his sixth different country at the age of 26 for Gabriel Heinze. Policini. Mascherano. I'm going to have a look at his passport, by the way. I'm not sure he's 20. Sorin. Penetrating play again by Argentina, and Gilly Gonzalez has won the corner.
Their build-up play is terrific to watch. They don't have the front players to go long. Everything is short, everything's through the midfield, everything's into feet. Trying to do over elaborate, it's almost as if they're trying to score the perfect goal, but they are terrific to watch, the Argentines.
Well, Cleverson has not recovered from that knock, so Diego of Santos is on as a replacement. Argentina corner is resulting in a spot of pushing, so Brazil have the respite of the free kick.
As Ayala had made the run right across the front there. Oh, was just slightly too deep.
Heinze. Free kick for the Brazilians. Quickly taken as well. This is Adriano. Alex. Diego. Very rarely that Brazil use Alex and Diego, particularly so early on in a game as this. They play very much a similar position. Painful for Adriano and Kili Gonzalez.
Well, Adriano reckons Kili Gonzalez was high, and I think he's got a case here. We're both on high.
Carlos Alberto Pereira, the Brazil coach, in his third spell in charge. Of course, he was the man who oversaw the World Cup win in the United States in 1994. No long-lasting damage for either player. Seven World Cups these two nations have won between them. Brazil, of course, with five. By Edu, a little bit of freedom for the Arsenal man now. Adriano. Luis Gonzalez nips it. Here's Tevez. Luzão surely holding Tevez. And the resulting yellow card.
Yeah, he had a little tug at Tevez when he was turned originally. You see the left hand there, had a little tug at him. Referee trying to give Tevez the advantage, thought he might be getting clear. But it's a free kick in a very decent position here.
Carlos Tevez winning only his eighth cap in this final. Gonzalez plants it in there, and Ayala! Nobody able to get a touch. kept in though by Javier Zanetti. An important stretch there from Julio Cesar. By the way, Ayala might well have got to that.
Yeah, Brazil really stretched by the ball and difficult one to defend. Eventually it was Ayala who got it back across goal. This was the save from Cesar eventually.
Luizão has got the problem. Eventful game he's had. There's a clash of heads there. Talking earlier about Argentina going to the Olympics next month in Greece. Brazil were confident of getting there, but they lost out to Paraguay in the South American qualifying back in January. Brazil only needed a draw in that final match and lost it 1-0. Had they got there, they would have brought their full Olympic team here to this tournament. That was the plan. Here comes the corner. Diego, nicely weighted pass. Picture looks bright for Luizão. I think he's going to be back with us shortly. Kick here for Brazil.
Yeah, it's one that Alex might be able to throw into a very dangerous area as well. Needlessly giving away free kick, high feet.
Well, looking to produce the same quality which led to the equalising goal on the stroke of half time when Alex found the head of Luizão. He's not come forward but is back on the field again. Mascherano. Colaccini. Zanetti. Ball is a moment's concern for Brazil, but a free kick's been given.
They look quite happy at the moment to drop off and sit in, Brazil, much as they did late in the game against Uruguay in the semi-final. Argentina, the only side trying to make the game at the moment.
Brazil only just squeaked through into this final on penalties against the Uruguayans. Just a reminder that if it's level at the end of 90 minutes, no extra time, straight to penalties. That's how the Copa America 2004 would be decided. Here's Tevez. Oh, good pass. Zanetti! Terrific block from Neri.
Wonderful play from Tevez. Terrific feet. Appeared to have nowhere to go. All of a sudden, picks out Zanetti, could have taken it, and probably should have taken it first time on his right side. And the touch was a costly one.
Alex labouring. So the skipper departs, and on comes Felipe. In many ways, a similar player to Alex, who's rather lost his way in terms of the senior international setup in the last few years. Opportunity now for Felipe to come on and do something special. Strong work from Mason, eventually draws the foul out of Rosales.
I think Vince has been as effective as Delgado in that position tonight. wonder if we'll see Figueroa before too long as well.
Well, Rosales looking towards the touchline, wondering if his number is up. It is. His first start in the competition after coming on for Delgado on four occasions previously in this tournament. And this time it's a role reversal. Here comes Delgado. Solid performer he's been in this tournament. Adriano.
An example of the difference between the two sides, though. Brazil want to go long, Kevin, they can't. There's a good long ball played up. Fabiano all over Colaccini to win the knockdown. And all of a sudden, Adriano's got a chance to have a shot at goal from the edge of the box. Argentina don't have that option. Everything has to be shot.
Delgado straight into the action. I think he was trying to cut it back, and maybe it took a slight bobble.
Yeah, I think it did. This pitch, anything but ideal. Surface very poor. Did well to get in behind. It might have set up a fraction for him.
Somewhat agricultural challenge there from Mason. Diego. Gonzalez. Needless free kick given away by young Diego, 19-year-old who Tottenham showed an interest in for 18 months or so. There's been some talk that the reigning European club champions Porto are looking closely at Diego as a possible replacement for Deco, who's now moved to Barcelona. Luis Gonzalez. Tevez. Driven in by Heinze. Delgado's knocked back here. Zanetti. Gustavo Neri preventing any telling cross. It's a corner.
Yeah, Zanetti didn't fancy it on his left side there. Picked out well with the cutback.
Javier Delgado with the Argentina corner. Flying header. Didn't miss by much. What a competitor. He isn't the tallest, you know, Ayala, but what spring he's got.
Guy attacks it so well. He's so aggressive. And he's always the target. Giving away a height advantage certainly to Luisao there, but get up well.
One of the side looked like scoring. It is Argentina still. Luis Fabiano and Adriano remain in a firm stranglehold from the three solid Argentinian centre-backs of Colaccini, Ayala and Heinze. Mason. Straight to Ayala. Sorin. Zanetti. Luis Gonzalez for Delgado. Zanetti. Ball gets away from Maidu. Possibilities here for Argentina. Thumped away by Mason.
A bit of relief for Edu there, dived in, ended up wrong side. team again settling into the pattern of the first half.
This is beginning to get quite one-sided now, worryingly, as far as Brazil are concerned. Sorin, Tevez. Juan tries to prevent the corner, and does so. There's an urgency about Argentina. They know they've got a measure of control on this match now. Luis Gonzalez. Mason had to be very careful there. I think Kili Gonzalez looking at the referee more in hope than expectation.
Oh, I wonder. It's on his right side, he's got his body between his opponent and the ball there. While he kicks the ground, you're dead right, Kevin.
Free kick here now for Brazil. Opportunity to stem the tide of Argentina attacks. Now that Alex has gone off, Felipe will get over these. They do. Luis Fabiano! Wonderful defending.
That's all it takes, though. Argentina will be well aware of that. They're all the possession in the world.
They know they can't afford to switch off.
Exactly.
For sure.
Exactly. I think the pattern of the game and the dominance that Argentina have enjoyed is a vindication of the Bielsa's decision to change the shape of the side. But you try telling that to the people if they come up short here.
This is Heinze. Easy to get around that ample frame of Adriano.
So much going for him, Adriano. I don't think there's a real weakness in his game. I know he's predominantly left-sided, but he's good in the air, he's quick, he can hold the ball in. That too must be worth a quarter.
Ayala. Tevez. Sorry. Tevez. Straight down the throat of Julio Cesar. Half a chance though.
Yeah, a little Tevez involved again. He really has been a live wire tonight.
Diego has a problem here. Mascherano came in with the mistimed challenge.
He does the ugly side of the business so well, this fella. Just 20 years of age, turned 20 last month. And he breaks up so much of what the opposition try to produce.
Plays for River Plate, by the way, Mascherano. He's come through all junior levels in the Argentinian ranks, unlike Luis Gonzalez, who's been equally impressive alongside him. He just came straight into the senior side. Different routes taken, but both top quality prospects. But a real clutch of outstanding young players coming through. The future of Argentinian international football looks very rosy indeed. Even people, the experienced players, have got a good two or three years left in them. At least you would think, the likes of Ayala at 31 and Kili Gonzalez at 29. Zanetti, 30.
Neri wasn't for giving it up, was he? On the few occasions we've seen him in that position. The second half has spent most of it camped in his own 18-yard line.
Zanetti. Lido sticking diligently to his task there. It's a very important part of this Brazilian performance at the moment. They've got to hang in there just as they did when they were a goal down for quite a period in the first half. No room for Fabiano. D'Alessandro is stripped and ready to come on. We are 16 minutes plus stoppage time away from a possible penalty shootout to decide the destiny of the Copa America 2004. No extra time, straight to penalties if it's level at the end of 90.
Interesting to see who's coming off here. Be surprised if it's Tevez. But D'Alessandro, the natural replacement, you would think. Luis Gonzalez, for me, has done well. Doubt very much if it would be him.
D'Alessandro, like Tevez, it's Luis Gonzalez who departs. It's a little surprising.
Well, I think he's had a smashing game. I mean, he won the penalty, he's been going box to box, he's gone beyond Tevez when he drops off. It's been a pretty decent contribution from Gonzalez.
Andres D'Alessandro of Wolfsburg in Germany comes on to win his 17th cap. It goes against Sorin.
That just so reluctant to let this fella turn and get running at him.
They do. Gustavo Neri telegraphed the pass. And here's D'Alessandro for Delgado. Forward and it's beyond Juan here. This is Tevez. Long legs of Juan got to him in the end.
That's terrific defending. See the reluctance to commit himself there so quick, or the feet of this little guy. Always liable to give away a penalty.
Argentina still look aside most likely. D'Alessandro.
Terrific challenge, had to be absolutely spot on.
Ball down the middle and goalkeeper only just got there to deny Tevez. There was a moment's hesitation from Julio Cesar.
Yeah, he was even money there, Tevez, as the ball dropped in behind.
This is Felipe.
Real Madrid.
Is football one of the few in this squad at home. He's in Brazil with Flamengo. Felipe again. Oh, almost a superb turn there from Fabiano. Shot him in the inning. Ayala was there to block. Back in by Edu. And Gustavo Neri follows wide.
Yeah, all shoulders to the wheel there. Ball ricocheting about the penalty area. All it would take for Argentina to lose this match, despite what they've put into the game so far.
Gustavo Neri had both shots in that moment. Cause for concern for Argentina, and there haven't been too many in this match. Claiming he was obstructed there by Zanetti, referee from Paraguay. Carlos Amaria, not interested. Brilliant from Delgado. Drew. Hey! Brazil are having to work hard to keep them out. Heinze. Ricciardo helping it back in. Safety first from Lewis out.
But he might have done better, Delgado. Then there was support for him in the box. Had he managed to turn it across the face of goal.
Bielsa is like a caged tiger at the moment, fouling that touchline, wondering where this elusive goal is going to come from. D'Alessandro with the corner. Header out with Semedo. Luis Fabiano. That won't please Pereira. They need some possession, Brazil. D'Alessandro has been very busy since he came on. Delgado. Mascherano. Zanetti. Tevez. Doing a lot of work, Edu, but that wasn't very clever. Will it be costly? Serene again making one of those darting runs.
Right-footed pass this time from Tevez. Lifted the head, saw the run, just couldn't quite pick Sorin out.
The movement on the substitutes bench, and by way of underlining the way this game is going, Brazil are bringing a defender on. This is Chris. The oldest player in the squad, and looks as though he's going to replace Luis Zhao, who's been struggling ever since he had that clash of heads with Ayala. I suspect if you asked him what tournament he was playing in at the moment, I'm not sure you'd get the right answer.
Yeah, I took a real bang, didn't he?
Well, he gave away a penalty in the first half, but he scored his first senior goal for Brazil with a close-range header on the stroke of half-time, and now his final ends after 81 minutes. So straight swap at centre-back, Chris for Luis Zhao. Cap for the man from Cruzeiro, had a brief spell in Europe in the Bundesliga with Bayer Leverkusen. The man he's partnering now still plays there, Juan. Diego. Zanetti. There's been a resilience about this Brazil performance. They've had to dig deep. Still, they hold a classier side in Argentina at bay. Not quite what the referee intended, but Mascherano has possession back here for Argentina. Here's Zanetti. Delgado. He's almost got the prayer mat out of the moment, Bielsa. Amsterdam tournament. Arsenal, River Plate of Argentina, of course, Ajax and Panathinaikos. Lots to look forward to there, 5:30 Friday, Sky Sports 1. Football returning with a vengeance. Season will be upon us before we know it. More live football than ever coming up this coming season here on Sky Sports. Still no nearer to finding out who's going to be lifting the Copa America very shortly. Argentina will feel they've done enough to win it. Mascherano, it's not his area of the field.
That might be just what it takes though, Kevin. You know, Argentina at the moment just trying to pass their way through Brazil, but they have so many numbers go side now, there's very little room to work in.
Well, Luizão is on his way to hospital for a precautionary check, of course, with any head injuries. No chances will be taken there. Mistake by Renato. This is D'Alessandro. Javier Zanetti. The ball for D'Alessandro. Argentina continue to knock on the door. The house stands firm still.
Yeah, no real threat. I mean, they're having all the possession, but there's less threat about Argentina now. Principally because Brazil have dropped off, the midfield have dropped off. So many players go side now. And Brazil look as if they would take penalties off you right now if you offered them it.
Heinze. Kili Gonzalez. Delgado did well to keep that in. Tevez. No problems for Brazil. Mason. Not a very good header. That was a risky one from Ayala, of all people.
I think it took a little dip as he came into the box here, an awkward type for him. By and large, he's defended up front post area pretty well again tonight, Ayala. Slight misjudgment, but did enough.
I think we almost blink in disbelief when he makes an error. There are so few of them. Policini heading towards the last 3 minutes plus any time to be added on. Any goal now would more than likely be a winning one. Decent cross. Serene inevitably is in there. Oh, it's in! Brilliant goal from Delgado! And is that the goal that gives Argentina a record 15th Copa America? What a moment for Bielsa.
Well, you've got to say it's no more than they deserve. They've been on the front foot the entire match. It's Sorin again who's in there putting the pressure on. He knew he had to take it early, Delgado. He's going to be pressed. Very little back lift. Oh, what a finish. Behind Cesar before he knew much about it. And that is a wonderful finish from the substitute. And again, it's a vindication of Bielsa's substitutions. I think he's got his shape right tonight. And I think this substitution might just have won it for him.
It's his second goal for his country. By far, of course, the most important. He got a yellow card for his goal celebrations. But you could understand his delight. Now there's got to be real urgency about Brazil. They stayed patient, Argentina. They probed at that Brazilian defence and finally found the opening. And how fitting that Sorin had a part in it.
as Tevez quite happily just shielding the ball out in the touchline. Argentina will now try and see this one out. And they do keep such good possession. Brazil are going to find it hard to get the ball.
Tevez. Taunting Mason. Exactly what his coach would have wanted. What a finish though from Delgado. No stopping that. D'Alessandro winning the free kick.
I'll be surprised if this is played into the box. This, I'd imagine, will be taken short.
It is. Tevez and D'Alessandro want to play their own game down in this corner again.
A terrific finish. Not an easy one to take. Awkward tight for them. Got right over it.
Brazilians are being really frustrated here now. This is the way to run the clock down. We're into stoppage time. Kick has been given. There are 3 minutes to be played. Brazil needs something special and very quickly. They've got a chance to get players forward now. They have the free kick. Chris and Juan have launched pacey runs forward. This is going to be planted right into the heart of that Argentinian penalty area from Gustavo Neri, or is it? No. Decides to play it short. Header out by Sorin. Not sure they took the right option there, Brazil. One further substitution here from Bielsa. Carlos Tevez comes off to a terrific ovation. Certainly impressed the man alongside me tonight, all this afternoon.
Yeah, certainly has. I thought he had a disappointing semi-final, but he's been outstanding tonight. You're playing further forward, but he's been one of the real stars for Argentina tonight.
Defender Quiroga is on for the final moments. And we have a minute left of the Copa America final 2004. And Javier Delgado looks as though he's won it for Argentina. Renato plants it forward. Away by Ayala. Diego. Ball's dropping here. Oh, it's an equaliser. Unbelievable. Adriano with his seventh goal of the tournament. With virtually the last kick of the match. What a tournament for the 22-year-old from Inter Milan. Squares it up at 2-2 and we're on the way to penalties.
Oh, that's absolutely astonishing. Brazil look dead and buried. They throw in a diagonal, hoping to get a knockdown. Ayala's won so many of them, didn't win that one cleanly. But what a terrific finish.
Well, he's been around the block a few times, Carlos Alberto Pereira, but how he enjoyed it, the 61-year-old coach. That left foot, lethal again. tournament to remember. And it may still end in glorious success. But it's going to be decided by penalties, and there's some ill feeling as the referee has blown for full time.
One of the few times that Argentina haven't won a clean header, they've won so many of the first ball, any time the ball has been played in. Bit of afters here, Adriano involved.
And still the arguments continue. Ayala wanting to lead them. The referee's calling for some assistance here. Ayala gesticulating towards Adriano, it would seem. Now the police have got involved. I think he felt as if, he squared an arm into him there, Adriano, and that's what Ayala was complaining about.
Yeah, but he appeared to take a backhander there from Adriano. But it's paid off big time for Brazil.
Bielsa, the coach, having a word now with the Paraguayan referee. What a dramatic finale to this 2004 final.
Well, just you wonder how psychologically this might affect Argentina, who must have thought they were home and dry.
Well, they would have been deserved winners. I don't think anyone, even Brazil, would argue about that. What a tournament for Adriano. Seven goals for the 22-year-old Brazil striker, and that late, late left-foot shot means we are heading for penalties. In the meantime, let's get a word from the boys back in the studio.
Now, one of the police were on the pitch there. I thought they'd been a robbery, Argentina, I should think. they thought they'd won it, hadn't they, Bobby?
We did as well, Rob, didn't we? Once Delgado scored that second goal. But Trevor said off air that once they loaded one in, and that's the first time they'd really put one in into the penalty area, that it dropped down to that wonderful, wonderful left foot of Adriano. I think what got upset Ayala was the arm that came out. But there again, all's fair in love and war, and that's what it was out there. It was a battle.
So 3 minutes of regulation time to go, and it looked like Argentina had won it. Sorin, yet again, the left back in a centre-forward position.
Well, they were continually loading balls in the box, and they got nobody really with any height to head the ball, except Sorin. He made a couple of good runs, didn't quite get it. On this occasion, he heads it back across goal. It's a poor attempt there by a Brazilian player to clear it. There's nothing wrong with that. That's a fantastic shot from Delgado. This is the equaliser, just a ball loaded into the box. It's a fighting ball, they don't clear it. Adriano flicks it up, and you know, once he gets that onto his left foot, there's only one place that was destined for, and that was the back of the net.
Well, we thought Brazil were playing for penalties around about sort of, 10, 15 minutes into the second half. In the end, it's the way it turned out. They've had their practice at taking penalties in this tournament, of course. The semi-final, however, will it make any difference, Luisao and Alex? Neither of those two players on the pitch. They were one of the regulation five in this penalty shootout.
In papers I've read of late, Pereira made sure that they practiced for three solid days, and they've been practicing and practicing. And I think you can see that from the evidence that we're witnessing in front of our eyes now. And it'll be interesting to see who they will nominate instead of the two players that they've taken off. But Alex is one of those who scored the winning goal the other evening.
Argentina thought they'd won the game.
Yeah.
Now the momentum is swung towards Brazil. Brazil can't believe they're still in the game, because they've had one kick in the first half on the stroke of half-time, they score with it from Luisao. And they have one kick at the end of the second half, and they score with it from Adriano. In between, probably Argentina have had 90% of the possession. But now it's anyone's game, and it depends on who can keep their nerve. But it's not just about nerve, it's about, you know, quality and technique. I think Pereira was quick to point that out, that after the penalty shootout in the semi-final, it was down to his players showing the better technique.
We saw this right in the very first game. Luis Fabiano, 90 minutes, beat Chile after they'd missed a penalty. Are you saying now then for you Brazil are favourites, Trevor?
from the very start of the tournament, I tipped Argentina. They've always been my favourites because they've got the best squad. They've got the best players, the better quality players. When you look at Brazil, this is basically a reserve team. And Brazil have been absolutely delighted to get to a final. They're even more happier now they've got to a penalty shootout. I think they go into the penalty shootout as the favourites because the momentum is with them. At the moment, Argentina are on an absolute downer.
Well, they won't have Luis Sao. We just saw the head clash. That means he won't be one of the penalty kick takers for Brazil. He took the first one in that semi-final. Which way is this going to go then? A little pat for Julio Cesar. Will he be the hero? Or will Argentina go on to lift the trophy for the 15th time? It would break the record. Currently, they're joint record holders with Uruguay. Which way will it go? The referee, Carlos Amarilla, takes down the names of the penalty takers. And here to guide you through the action of the drama that is the penalty shootout for the 2004 Copa America title is David Provin and Kevin Keatings.
Well, Rob, as you rightly said, Luizão took that first penalty in the semi-final shootout against Uruguay on his way. He may already be in hospital now for a checkup on that head injury, which forced him off late in the match. The other four successful penalty kick takers for the Brazilians are out there from the semi-final shootout. Luis Fabiano, Adriano, Alex, or rather Alex, of course, was substituted as well, wasn't he? So he would normally be their first choice in regulation play to take a penalty. So he'd be out of the equation too, but Renato is there. As Trevor Francis was rightly saying, it's all about a steady nerve now. Those who have the confidence to want to step forward in a major international final and test their nerve from the spot. As we've been saying throughout this competition, the penalty kick taking has been of a very high order indeed. And Bobby Gould was absolutely right. Brazil did practice for 3 days solidly ahead of that semi-final against Uruguay, just in case, and it paid off. Ever been involved in penalty shootouts, David?
Took one penalty in my entire career, Kevin, and a testimonial missed it, never took another one. Used to go missing at this moment.
Embrace between the two goalkeepers, Abondanzieri of Argentina and Julio Cesar of Brazil, who apart from one error in the semi-final has had an excellent tournament. I think they found a more than capable goalkeeper in this competition. Brazil, 24-year-old Julio Cesar of Flamengo. Bit of mathematics going on from our Paraguayan referee.
I think he had a good game tonight. He let it go where possible, and when it did get a bit out of hand, he stepped in. I've enjoyed the contact in this tournament. It's something that has been taken out of the game in Europe, but I think it's safe to say it's still a man's game in South America.
Been a lot to look back on and enjoy. Every match has been live with us on Sky Sports. We sincerely hope you've enjoyed some top South American football. Some of the very big names haven't been here, of course, but in many ways that just added to the interest of all of us involved, really, to see some of the players in these top nations who are just below the top first choice 11, if you like, the emerging players. And we've seen so many really quality youngsters who we're going to be hearing a lot of in the months and years to come. Argentina would love to send themselves off to the Olympics next month with a successful outcome to this penalty shootout. I'm quite sure why it's been delayed so long. Only that man knows. Certainly the delay is not helping the butterflies in the stomach of the allotted penalty takers. still our Paraguayan referee is not prepared to let the shootout start. He's telling the Brazilian coaching staff to retreat off the playing surface. Not sure what he does for a living, but probably lay a decent bet he's a headmaster. He's got that look about him. Wonder what's going through the mind of Marcelo Bielsa, the Argentina coach, at the moment as we look at the Brazilian bench. But it's his first major international final. Bielsa took over from Daniel Passarella after France World Cup 98. The first Argentinian coach in recent times to stay in a job after failing to win the World Cup. They've backed him to the hilt, despite a lot of criticism from Argentina supporters and the media. But it's going to be Argentina who will get the shootout finally underway. Memories go back now to previous penalty shootouts between these two. 1995 Copa America quarter-final, Brazil won 4-2 on penalties. 2 years earlier, Brazil won on penalties again in a quarter-final. It's D'Alessandro. Oh, what a start for Julio Cesar in Brazil.
Yeah, it certainly is. Just a guess here from Cesar. And he gets lucky. Not needing off the corner from D'Alessandro, who's come on as substitute tonight. He would have been one of Argentina's bankers, you'd imagine, in this situation. Such a good left foot.
Well, we remind you, Brazil took 5 penalties in the semi-final shootout against Uruguay. Scored all 5. Adriano, everything has been going his way in this tournament. Can he hold his nerve one more time? You bet he can.
Well, just a striker in complete confidence at the moment with his game. Came up close and just opened his body at the last moment. Keeper might have expected him to power it, but quite happy to go for placement.
10 goals Adriano's now scored in 14 senior internationals for Brazil. A record for even the great Ronaldo to admire. Now, Manchester United's Gabriel Heinze. Oh! That's on its way to Colombia.
Well, always disappointing when you don't hit the target, and it's nowhere near the target.
It's a disastrous start to the shootout for Argentina. If Brazil can slot their second away, a massive advantage. Manchester United, Heinze misses. Arsenal's Edu looks calm and composed. Can he make it 2-0 for Brazil? Penalties from the Brazilians have been absolutely top-notch.
That's a big cushion as well. The two-goal cushion is so important, Kevin. It takes so much of the pressure now off the Brazilians who are about to step up. Piles it onto Argentina.
See if you can slot them away in the soft sand on the Copacabana beach. It's easy out here. Now then, this really has to go in for Argentina. Kili Gonzalez, who scored in the first half of this final from the spot. Scores again.
That's a terrific penalty. I think even if Cesar goes to his left here, he's never getting this.
Still, Brazil hold the advantage and still a penalty in hand. If Brazil make it 3 out of 3, then Argentina cannot afford another miss. ...19 years old, Diego of Santos. He's not had a bigger moment than this in his young career. Perfectly into the corner. Really good attempt from the goalkeeper.
That's such a good penalty. Goalkeeper's actually yard off his line by the time the ball is struck. Guess it's right, still can't get down though.
Well,
that's the first right-footed penalty we've seen so far.
They're so close now. 3-1, Brazil lead. And Argentina, through Juan Pablo Sorín, have to score to keep the shootout alive. Well, I'm glad he scored.
Yeah, it'd have been a travesty if this fella had been remembered as the one who signalled Argentina's demise. What a good night he's had. Decides to go straight down the middle, as we've seen so often, goalkeeper guessing.
Centre-back Juan is given the opportunity to land Brazil their 7th Copa America title. If this goes in, the parties will be long and loud throughout Brazil tonight. Juan of Bayer Leverkusen scores. Brazil are the Copa America champions 2004.
You've got to say it's a bit of a travesty, Kevin. Certainly the Argentina, for me, by a distance, the better side tonight, but the better side doesn't always win the football match. And Brazil have nicked it. Principally, I think Adriano's willingness to contest the high ball in the last minute bought them a lifeline. I think the psychological blow for Argentina at that stage just too much for them to handle.
Very noticeable there, that hug of delight from the coach Pereira and the wise old man of Brazilian football, Mario Zagallo. World Cup winners, both of them. And now Copa America winners 2004. Brazil, so used to winning major international competition. You have to feel a huge amount of sympathy for a very talented Argentina. What were they, 20 seconds away, maybe even less than that, from the end of normal time, from winning it 2-1. But up popped the man of the tournament, being interviewed there, Adriano, to score his 7th goal in 6 matches. An outstanding record for the 22-year-old. And it's Brazil's championship. What a finale.
Yeah, it certainly was. Who said football was ever meant to be fair? And a real kick in the teeth for Argentina tonight. And they looked dead and buried. And Tevez had the ball down in the corner flag. It looked as if Argentina would run the clock down. They managed to get possession, lumped it on, and all of a sudden it was game on again.
The officials now putting together the podium. Very shortly we will have the presentation of the trophy. But let's look back at how it happened. It was a horrible start, wasn't it, for Argentina? D'Alessandro and Heinze both missing. Juan held his nerve, and that was the decisive spot kick which landed Brazil the championship and their 2nd successive penalty shootout win here in Peru. Well, they brought their B team here. All the big heads, all the big names left behind. The Ronaldos, the Ronaldinhos, Kaká, Cafu, Roberto Carlos. They'll all be back for the home game against Bolivia in September when the World Cup qualifiers resume. But Pereira becomes only the 2nd coach to win the World Cup and the Copa America. And the man who's been alongside him in this tournament, the great Mario Sergallo, was the other. Well, I think they'll be enjoying a glass of wine or two over those memories tonight.
I think it's been a terrific tournament all in, Kevin, and particularly for some of the emerging talent that you know, we've seen over the last couple of weeks, and not just from the two sides that we've watched tonight, but you know, right across the whole spectrum of South American football. Clearly, it is still in good shape. They're still producing players of outstanding technique.
Raw emotion there for Carlos Tevez, the 20-year-old who played such a big part in taking Argentina to this final. But there'll be brighter days ahead for him, and so many of the great young Argentinian players coming through, and Brazil have got their share too, and these two countries will continue to dominate for years to come, you would think, football in this region. A word too for Peru, who stays the tournament very well. They had one or two internal problems with their major airlines, which made getting around the country a little difficult for the media. Fans are inconsolable as well. The difference between success and failure very evident out there. But as Davy Proben was rightly saying, a tournament to savour. Wonder what's in store now for Bielsa. Horrible way to lose, not only with a late goal from Adriano, but a penalty shootout as well.
What's the point Trevor made at the top of the programme, Kevin? I don't think that his tactics were wrong, far from it. I think they were spot on tonight, and I think that the pattern of the game vindicated that, but he might try explaining that to the Argentine people tomorrow morning.
Yeah, you know how narrow-minded some people look at the game of football. From a tactical point of view, I think we all agree Bielsa picked an 11 which he felt would beat Brazil, and they so very nearly did. D'Alessandro and Heinze, those first two missed penalties, had the Argentinians very much on the back foot right from the start of that shootout. So used to winning, aren't they, Brazil? We're so used to seeing the shirts emblazoned with the famous name and the arms aloft, the smiles wide. He's had an excellent tournament, the goalkeeper, Julio Cesar. Sepp Blatter, the president of FIFA, who arrived in Peru last Friday. As we await the handing over of the trophy to Brazil. The crowd, the noisy Brazilian contingent as always are here to see the handing over of the trophy, which will be happening very shortly indeed. It's the disappointed runners-up who have to trudge forward first, of course. So it's not to be a record 15th Copa America success for Argentina. They brought the most experienced and talented squad to this competition, but only just fell short. Sorin, so adventurous, the left wing back. Ayala, the skipper, must have thought he'd be getting his hands on the trophy. Zanetti behind him. Well, winners, all of them, but losers on this occasion, and it will hurt.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think there's any consolation for the Argentine boys at the moment at all. They know they dominated the game. I don't think they could have played much better. And they've just been caught cold, but as we said early in the game, Kevin, you know, with Brazil's front pairing, you would never rule them out. They were always liable to nick one, and so it turned out.
Gabriel Heinze, looking forward to his career, of course, at Manchester United. It'll be delayed. He'll go to the Olympics, as so many of this largely young Argentinian squad will. There's Saviola, who hamstring injury kept him out of three successive matches from the group stage onwards. That was a blow to Argentina, that can't be underestimated. He missed the little Barcelona man. Generous applause for Argentina. Delgado, what are his thoughts at the moment? He must have thought he'd scored the winning goal in Copa America 2004, but Adriano had other ideas. Tevez, his time will come. Still the team to beat in the Olympics in Athens, paired with Serbia, Montenegro, Tunisia and Australia. They're having to receive the medals, but they're not staying around the neck very long. There's no place for losers at the top end of international football. We said earlier, the future is very bright for Argentinian football. Luis Gonzalez, Mascherano, Tevez, Delgado, all names, all young names that we'll be hearing so much of in the future. And now the officials await the winners. The ribbon on the medals changes from blue to red. First of all, the officials, Carlos Amaria of Paraguay, officiated the match very well. It wasn't the lucky omen in the end for Argentina, having taken charge of their 6-1 thrashing of Ecuador and their 1-0 defeat of the host Peru in the quarter-final. And that's what it's been all about. Copa America trophy 2004 will be etched, if not already, very soon with the name of Brazil. Adriano is going to receive, first of all, the man of the match trophy. Well, just to underline that Adriano has been voted the man of the match. There will be a trophy at some stage for him. Carlos Alberto Pereira, winner of the World Cup in 94, as we've said, along with Mario Zagallo, who follows him onto the podium, the only two men to win a World Cup and a Copa America as coach. Now the victorious Brazilian players, average age 24, many of these figures with good senior international careers ahead of them. Once the big talent moves out of the way, it might be a few years yet that some of these youngsters will have to wait, but some of them are already pushing very hard at the door.
Yeah, the big talent might not have a choice in this, certainly for the front pairing. Luis Fabiano and Adriano have sent out a real message here that they're ready to play for Brazil, and even though Ronaldo and Ronaldinho are the men in possession, they're very difficult, Adriano in particular, very difficult to leave this young man out of the side.
Adriano is in lofty company, and there he is, becoming the first player to score more than six goals in a Copa America since Pelé back in 1959. I think he'll have that pretty high on his CV. delight is there for all to see for these young Brazilian players. The oldest player in the squad, only 27. They've ridden their luck. Uruguay were a shade unfortunate not to beat them in the semi-final. Argentina certainly unfortunate not to win this final. But sometimes the lady luck smiles down on you. But they certainly kept their nerve admirably in the semi-final and final penalty shootouts. They must have the biggest coaching staff in world football, Brazil. Hope they've got enough medals to hand out. So the passing over the medals is complete. All that remains now is the handing over of the trophy. Since the format was changed in 1993 in this Copa America, Brazil reaching their fourth final in five tournaments. Winners in 1997, winners in 99. And it's some trophy, isn't it?
De la Copa America. Al capitán del equipo campeón, Brazil.
Alex, the captain. Lifts the trophy up and winners again in 2004, Brazil.
Señoras y señores, agradecemos infinitamente al público peruano.
Well, they've still got some way to go to catch Argentina and Uruguay with 14 wins apiece. But it's seven wins now in South America's Copa America. Congratulations to Brazil, commiserations to Argentina. And the Copa America 2004 in Peru is complete.
Carlos Alberto Pereira does it again. World Cup in 94 and now the Copa America in 2004. Brazil, 8 seconds away from going out. Trevor, can you believe they've done it this way?
I can't, and I'm sure the Brazilian players can't believe it either. You know, they've practically given it up. But they never looked like scoring, did they? You know, there was so much possession from Argentina. They'll look back on moments, defining moments. We spoke about the miss from Dario Silva in the semi-final, which was the worst miss I've ever seen. Tevez's miss tonight wasn't too far behind. It was a bad mistake by him. But then, you know, Delgado looks as if he had won the game for them. But that late goal from Adriano, you knew once he flicked it up onto his left foot, it was in the back of the net. And it just shows, you know, how important it is to have in your side a top marksman, because without him, obviously, they wouldn't be walking around now with that trophy.
Poignant pictures we just saw there as Brazil were lifting the Copa America trophy, Bobby. Argentina were traipsing disconsolately off the pitch. You've got to feel sorry for, well, your favourite player of the tournament, Sorin, the likes of Luis Gonzalez, Achille Gonzalez as well, et al. In that Argentinian side. Tevez as well, one springs to mind.
When you look at the game, Argentina play football. I think Brazil played Monopoly tonight. And what they played at the end, they played their get-out-of-card jail. And they were so fortunate to win the game. But that's football. That's what we're all here for. We realise that you've got the potential of a great final. But the beautiful game never won tonight. Tactics won. And unfortunately, tactics that didn't work for Argentina. And Bielsa will look back in the cold light of day and know he got it wrong, because his two fullbacks didn't get the natural width that we've seen them earlier on in this tournament. And that's where they fell short. No natural width in the Argentinian game tonight.
OK, more from Bobby and Trevor coming up in a couple of minutes' time as Argentina pay the penalty for missing penalties. D'Alessandro and Manchester United's new big money signing, Heinze, failing from the spot. But Brazil have won it thanks to Juan. All the analysis coming up after the break.
Thank you. Premiership football. More internationals. The new season on Sky Sports. Are you ready for more?
Something is about to happen. That should happen.
Survival guide, starting with terrorist attack. Terror Alert, the all-new series, Thursday 9 o'clock, Sky One.
The Sunday Night Film, in association with Zafira from Vauxhall.
A future where emotions are forbidden, where clerics keep the peace, and love does not exist.
You're too late, sir. The time lock is engaged.
First thing you learn about emotion is that it has its price.
I'm coming.
Christian Bale.
You really should learn to knock.
Equilibrium. Next Sunday at 8, Sky Movies 1.
August, there's more.
Golf swings into action with the US PGA Championship and NEC Invitational.
A double serving of tennis with the ATP Masters from Cincinnati and the US Open.
World Cup and Sky Bet Elite League Speedway continue.
Pulsating cricket action in the Tote Sport League Plus 2020 finals.
Watch the School of Hard Knocks as Super League gets closer to the playoffs.
August on Sky Sports.
Well, I imagine you wish you'd put your money on Colombia then, Clive.
Well, I imagine you with your mouth taped shut, Brian.
Sky Bet. It matters more when there's money on it.
To the years 1919, 1922, 49, 89, 97 and 99, at the year 2004. For the seventh time, Brazil are champions of South America. They have won the Copa America on a penalty shootout after high drama at the end of the game. Trevor and Bobby are alongside me. It was looking good for Argentina, wasn't it? In that first half in particular, right up to the end of the first half. They're 1-0 up, a penalty conceded by Luis Al, Trevor.
Yeah, there was no doubt about, you know, whether it was a penalty or not. It was a poor challenge from Luis Al, and, you know, the referee had no hesitation in giving the penalty. But then you thought that was enough, you know, to take them into a half-time lead. But this is the challenge here. It's a horrible challenge. The ball just nicked away and... you know, it's clearly a foul, but Gonzalez has proved himself to be a very good penalty taker, as Alex has with his free kick taken. It's a low trajectory, and Luis Al gets there just before, doesn't he? Gets the header in. It's a good header.
Story to repeat itself, that just before half-time, then into the second half, Bobby, and Argentina take the lead. Cesar Delgado been on the pitch, what, about 24 minutes?
Yeah, great knockdown, and then just at the end here, you see the little build-up with Brazil. Diego goes forward, just lifts the ball into the middle, knocked down, one left foot, what a drive. We all knew in the studio here that what he was going to do with it. He was going to finish up in the back of the net.
It was a straightforward ball from Diego into the box with his right foot, but he's come on for Alex. And I'm convinced Alex wouldn't have tried that with his right foot.
Is there a problem with Argentina? I mean, is it just bad luck that at the end of each half they've conceded? Is there a fact that Brazil keep playing for the full period until the end of the whistle, or do Argentina just switch off perhaps at the end?
The Argentinian press now will absolutely hammer the manager because he's got it wrong, they've lost the game. He's got the best players, and in this tournament, he's got the best team. What he should have done was said, right, I'll back myself against Brazil because we've got the best team. He's been worried about the opposition. He's been worried about Fabiano and Adriano. So he's changed his tactics to try and nullify the front two. He's done that, but in doing so, I think it's taken away from his team.
OK, well, if Bielsa is going to get criticised, Pereira perhaps will get sainted or whatever the word is. not really up on those technology, but Brazil have been practising their penalties. Bobby, don't know about Argentina, but Argentina missing crucial moments in the penalty shootout.
Yeah, Rob, you said at the time, why did D'Alessandro take that first penalty? We expected Gonzalez to take it. And then Hines comes up and David Beckham like over the top. But the penalties from Brazil were just superb. They really, really were. And we couldn't get over, actually, the counting everyone, the amount of left-footers there were out there today. It's incredulous.
Six of the eight were by left-footers.
Yeah, fantastic. And then Juan just comes up, side-foots it home. Alex goes off injured and ends up a hero with the Copa America Cup. Strange game, isn't it?
Why did D'Alessandro take that first one, not Kili Gonzalez? Can you work that one out? Because Kili Gonzalez was taking them during the tournament in normal play.
I can only think that it was instructions from the manager. I think that, you know, when it comes to a penalty shootout like that, you know, you get some players that volunteer to take them. You get others don't want to go anywhere near it. And there's always going to be somebody that has to take the first one. Now, whether D'Alessandro said, I'll take the first one, or whether it's been, you know, the instructions from Bielsa. We're never going to be privy to anything like that. But obviously, when you are taking the first penalty, it's absolutely imperative that you score and put yourself into a 1-0 lead. Having lost a goal in the last minute, the last thing they wanted, they're already on a downer, was to lose the first penalty. It was uphill from there.
Very, very quickly, Bobby, your abiding memory of this tournament, your biggest moment.
My biggest moment? Oh, that's a difficult question, but competitive-wise and goal-wise, we've seen 70-plus goals here, and that is entertainment, Rob.
Similar theme. I think that every manager has been very positive. They've all gone out to try and score goals, and we've seen some, a variety of goals, but of great quality. We've seen some wonderful free kicks, long-range shooting from 25 yards, and my goal, the best goal for me, was Alvarez for Bolivia against Peru. Wonderful skill.
OK, my thanks to Bobby and Trevor for joining me here. July the 18th, 1994, Pereira won the World Cup on penalties. 10 years and 8 days later, he's won the Copa America on penalties. Congratulations to Brazil.
Sí, señor. Muy bien.
Sánchez, mira, Marco!
On the shot. Oh, what a fabulous goal! Yeah, goalkeeper's out. It's surely a goal. Oh! Oh! He's in the mood, all right. Unbelievable! Andy Herron, 2 seconds from the end. Goal! What can you say about technique like that? To the final of the Copa America. And the final is Brazil against Argentina.